We're taking up case number 48563, which involves, Megan Boswell. She's the custody of the sheriff, president of the courtroom, represented by Mr. Sproles. It's in court today for today being March 2, 2012. So what's happening?
Judge, Ms. Boswell has agreed to waive her preliminary hearing and the case bound over to the grand jury.
Ms. Boswell, did you hear what your lawyer said?
Yes, Your Honor.
False reporting is class D felony, 2 to 12 years, right?
Yes.
2 to 12 years. Has to be disposed of in the criminal court. So what he says you want to do is not have any witnesses here at the preliminary hearing. Has he talked with you about that?
Yes, Your Honor.
And so if you want to give it up, you can do that. That means there won't be any witnesses. Do you have any questions about that?
No.
You give up the chance to hear witnesses testify, at least briefly, at least some testimony, and then your lawyer would ask them questions. You're giving up that opportunity. The case goes on to the criminal court. Have any questions about that?
No, Your Honor.
Raise your right hand. You swear that what you just said is the truth and what anything else you might say is the truth?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yeah, you should go with something.
Judge, it's already signed.
I need a reset sheet there, Mr. Picture one there, Mr. Let's see what the reset date is. What is that, May?
May 8th.
So if you run across the top, strike up General Sessions Court, put in criminal court, and the appearance time is May 8th. So your next appearance for this case will be May 8th at 9 o'clock in the criminal court in Bluff. Mr. Sproles is appointed only for this courtroom. Let's see the paper filled out by her. What's your birthday?
321-2001.
Address?
539 Muddy Creek Road.
You work anywhere in the Martin Jail?
Yeah.
Where was that?
Hunter T's Chicken Shack.
Say that again.
Hunter T's Chicken Shack, Your Honor.
Where's that?
In Blumwood, across from Morgan State.
So it's a restaurant, yes.
So are you not able to post a bond right now? I know you're being held for another court. So other than that, do you have any income other than that job? Mm-hmm. Raise your right hand, you swear the information is true. First of all, do you own any property? Mm-hmm. Raise your right hand, you swear the information is true.
Yes, Your Honor.
You swear to sign your name. That's when Mr. Sproles being appointed represents you at this procedure, this level. When you get to criminal court, if you need to have an appointed a lawyer, you'll have to ask the criminal court judge about that. Mr. Sproles is appointed only for this courtroom. Have any questions about that? Ms. Bonway, have any questions about that?
No, Your Honor.
Sheriff will give you a piece of paper that's got that court date that says, whatever you just said, 8th late or something, in criminal court. Go ahead, Mr. Sproles.
So, you asked the court to reduce her bond. She's currently unable to make a $25,000 bond. In support of that, Judge, we would show she's been a lifelong resident of Sullivan County. She was working prior to being incarcerated. She does have significant family ties to the community. As far as we know, her mother, all of her immediate family is here in Sullivan County. She has no prior criminal record and no prior failure to appear or other issues with missing court dates. And as I said, she has no prior record of danger to the community. So, Judge, our belief is that on a Class D felony, an appropriate bond for her, especially with no prior convictions would be approximately $10,000 bond. So we're asking the court to lower her bond to that amount that she may be able to make.
Keeping in mind that she's in jail also for the...
I understand, Judge, that, you know, this wouldn't clear the way, but if that juvenile court issue is resolved, we want her to be able to bond out.
Judge, just briefly in response, state has no evidence or any knowledge of any prior criminal history. However, the state would ask the court to consider the nature of this offense by reading of the affidavit of complaint. And based upon a reading of the affidavit of complaint, it'd be the state's position that the probability of conviction in this case would be high. And the court's already...
Like this charge, not anything else.
Correct. And that the court's already advised regarding the possible sentence of 2 to 12 years. There's an absence of any responsible members of this community that appears today before Your Honor to vouch for her or her reliability. And as far as her home situation, Your Honor, the address that she provided the court is not the address where she was residing at the time, and the place where she was residing at the time of this offense, it's my understanding she would not be able to return there. And she had only been at that residence for a brief period of time. And so based upon that, her, although she does have ties to the community, her residence is in question and is unstable. So the state would ask the court to consider those things and set it along.
So if I could just respond to the last issue there. The address that she provided is different than the address she was living at before. That's an address of a family member who she has made arrangements with. She
well, notice I didn't ask her to give you a
question. I understand. The address she gave you is one that she would be able to live at if she were to reach
I think the well, that's appropriate for the charges and what the circumstances are. And also consider the fact that there's another court order from a different judge. That's her court. That might be addressed in a kind of different. The first time is May 8th.
Yes, sir.
May 8th at 9 o'clock. The bond will continue at $25,000. Mr. Spoles is only appointed for this court.
Thank you.